my ammo here because we're gonna be fighting a boss. Oh, nice. It just gave me pretty much everything that I needed for that. Okay, here we go.
You woke the wrong dog. Ah, yeah!
Outrageous. I got an achievement for using her phase walk. Oh shit. Yes. We'll just equip that right now. Did it actually equip though? Yes, it did. We got a purple shield already. Oh wait, actually that's, I think, is automatically dropped by that creature. I don't remember if they have like a set drop or not. I know Nine Toes does. He should drop his gun. Yeah, right here. The clipper. But I don't need to use that now because I can get the elemental achievement for fire just by using that submachine gun, while also, you know, doing my submachine gun proficiency leveling. Oh good, just a way to fill up my inventory, why don't you? That's very nice. Thank you, game. Day's work.
That was the first step on your journey. You must listen. Who I am is not important. The first thing you must know, the vault is real. People will mislead you. They will try to use you, and you cannot be swayed in your purpose. The vault is here, and we will find it. This world is full of dangers. Steel yourself and go. I'll be watching.
I'm very curious as to what... Like, what weapon? Well, obviously we're gonna main the submachine gun, but I mean, like, what are my weapons? We're definitely not gonna do combat rifles. Shotguns? Well, it doesn't really matter. We're gonna be using this thing the most. Here, there'll be a side mission for us to do, if I remember correctly.
Get your meds here!
Can't even afford it. Oh should get another. I think it's another achievement at level 10, and then it goes like 25 and all that kind of stuff. Maybe it's level 15. I get the next achievement at. Yes, I am obsessed with achievements. I love. Damn it. Ooh, it's 5. Today has been fantastic. So far, at least. Hopefully we can keep up that trend. I've also finished a Guilty Crown today, and I haven't made my analyst entry for it yet, and I'll have to do that before I go to sleep.
Hey, newcomer. I've been looking for you.
Is there no end to my power?
We've got ourselves a new skill. And I am once again going to put it straight into Quicksilver. So now we've got a 10% increase. Oh, you can. It just feels so... Oh. The downside to this is, of course, my ammunition is going to go by a lot faster. Now, the OP build that I had in the co-op, I had the class mod where my ammunition was restoring itself. So I was able to restore ammunition really fast, like I was with my combat rifle in our other LP, the other Borderlands LP. Basically the same thing there, but with Lilith and a submachine gun instead. So once I get the opportunity to buy more submachine gun ammo, I'm gonna take it.
Well, I'll be damned. You killed 9 toads. You should get me a drink to celebrate sometime. Might want to check out the bounty board and see if anyone...
That's a grenade mod! Equip that, and you'll find that your protean grenades are suddenly more powerful.
Okay, so... Yeah, its accuracy goes down by like 1.3, which isn't bad at all. 11% recoil reduction, 33% fire rate, high elemental effect chance times 2. It has a lower magazine size, but other than that, the damage goes up quite a bit by 5, and the fire rate goes up a lot. That's what's very important.
And are now equipped with special abilities.
Oh, yes.
Always be on the lookout for new and different grenade mods to supercharge your arsenal.
When you get shot, you'll be happy I'm here.
Catch a ride. Okay, now I want to know if the catch a ride thing is broken.
You the one killing all the crab when people ask? The catch a ride near Firestone is more busted than my mama's girdle parts. Real appreciate you taking a poke at that. The system, not my mom. Hat dog down the skag down, know what I'm saying?
You gotta squeal before we come.
So, in co-op, and in our single player, and all that kind of stuff, this was broken to all shit. Not working. Will it work this time? Yes, it will. Okay, but we're not gonna do that just yet. We need to go talk to TK again. Ah, yes, the new symbols are great to tell me what, like, our story missions and what aren't.
Hey, newcomer. I've been looking for you.
That was difficulty hard. Difficulty tough. Ah, yes, the blade flower seeds and kill scar. Oh, we'll go do that stuff first.
Hey, now. If you ever need anything, anything at all, just let me know.
I should probably stop the recording soon to at least test and check to see what the audio sounds like. And also to see what the file sizes are going to be. Oh shit, look on the minimap. It even shows that there's a quest nearby, which is awesome. So that too is also new. That wasn't in the original Borderlands. It actually showing up, the waypoint showing up on my screen as a heads-up display stuff, as opposed to just on the compass. It's all very nice. Very nice new streamlined additions. And this feels really fun and addicting to play through because I know I'm working towards those achievements. The playtime is great too. Starting out with a fresh, like, Borderlands game is good on my Steam. And, I mean, we got this for free. People that already own the Game of the Year edition get enhanced as a free bonus. I'm happy those guys started to respawn after. Early there, I felt my butthole pucker a little bit. Whoa, look at this. You can't do that. Oh, you can. Hey. Go away, asshole. Should check to see if there's an ammunition upgrade yet, but I don't think we get those this early. Good. I'm already starting to feel the power of this class, of this character. Definitely going to be my new main. After spending like the past 7 years playing only Roland in the soldier class, it's now switched to Lilith. Achievement, Pyro, out. Getting 25 kills with fire weapons, I believe. And we get another skill here before we have to go fight that other guy. Scar. And I'm putting it right into this again. So now we have a 15% fire rate increase. Oh, man, this is already feeling so good. And the great thing is because, like, when I played before with Lilith for my first time playing with her, obviously, I was trying to just go for this first time using her skill trees, and I was going through her different skills, you know, focusing on melee and all that kind of stuff, because I thought that's what her power was going to be. And after having the experience of knowing what skills to not really go for, I can focus on them now and have a much easier time. I mean, look at that. That is ridiculous. That's what I mean. It's already starting. It's already started. An incendiary repeater, huh? Here's his leg. Okay, so that's done. Alright, I want to do this one here. No, this one here. It smells like a hospital in here all of a sudden. I don't know how to feel about that.
Hope I'm lucky.
Fire rate's way too low. And the elemental effect helps a lot. So here in the enhanced edition is Claptrap gonna tell us about the skull next to the enemy. information. Plenty of ammunition for this.
Hello!
Yep.
Did you know that by aiming your crosshairs at an enemy, your HUD can display your target's level, health, and chill streak? The higher level an enemy, the more dangerous they will be. If you see a skull, you better get out of there fast!
Here we go with the adult skags. We're gonna earn lots of XP here. I don't think we're gonna have as bad of a time as I would. This is how fast you can cut through these guys. But once I run out of ammunition, it's about to go. Guys on fire. Kill them now. Ammunition, please. I need lots of ammunition, please. Thank you. Because this place always has a badass skag. One thing I need with badass gang is a lot of ammo. Oh, also speaking of which, I think we'll go ahead and start using things like this, the repeaters. Lots of purple weapons down here at just level 1. Maybe they redid the rarity system with this. Careful with my ammunition here. I usually run out of ammo right here, in fact. Did in co-op, at least. Damn it. I need ammunition to drop, you little shits. Thank you. And here's where it gets hairy, and here's where there's always a fucking badass. Will there be a badass this time? Here. Up here. Is there one? Oh, wow. There's not. That's a first. Sad there wasn't, because that guy could have either dropped a lot of great loot or lots of XP at least. Speaking of, guess who is now getting 20% fire rate increase? Holy shit. And with the next level, of course, we're going to max that out because that's a very important thing to have early on here. Oh, there he is. Look at this SMG. It is ridiculous. I just ran out. Oh, that's fine. We can leave that behind. Yes, I'm leaving loot behind in a Borderlands game. What the fuck? Able to do that arena, because I can never get through all the rounds in the arena without dying at least once. But with Lilith's build, her crazy submachine gun, by that point I should have the 25% increase on fire rate. I'm thinking maybe, you know, although that's when you get to fight Alpha Skags, which have all the armor, so it might be a little bit more difficult. Buy a first aid kit! Yeah, no. No. I like the paint on that. Don't usually see bright, colorful weapons like that. And let's see, what grenade mod do we have? Grenade damage. Yes. So it's not an insta-equip anymore, I have to remember that, otherwise I might accidentally miss that. Depression. Fill me with your XP. I'm gonna get to level 10 and I think we're gonna take a break.
No, lucky you. I only shoot scat. Mostly, anyways.
Well, shit, we're gonna get it over here when we go turn this quest in. Look at these, even these paper things are like not a 2D attachment. Okay, let's go ahead and put that right into here. 25% fire rate increase. We've unlocked the increase my resistance to elemental damage and also I deal shock damage to nearby enemies while phase walking. Okay, let's listen to this. Oh, that is so good. Ugh. And it gets even better when we raise our proficiency, because now the more, like, for example, I think you can increase, maybe you can't increase fire rate. with this. I thought you could, but at least reload speed and damage. Maybe that's what I'm thinking of. The damage goes up with proficiency.
Mollywine guns shoot more lightning than the next leading competitor.
And let me see.
Always has the upper hand. Iron and you
doesn't look like we have any ammunition upgrades yet. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and stop the recording here, and we're going to check the audio and all that. So I'll see you in the next episode of Let's Play Borderlands Enhanced.